Good evening. The State Television Company of Western Armenia summarizes the most important events of the week. Today's broadcast. The first session of the second convocation of the National Assembly of Western Armenia will take place from 18 to 20 January. President Armenak Abrahamian spoke about the elections of local self-government body. Your Turkey is stolen from Armenians, Greeks and Kurds. It is being carried out a genetic study of the Armenian community of Cyprus. Genocide Education Project creates California educational program on genocide against Armenians. Armenian alphabet in Dutch engravings. The national team of Western Armenia had a camp and two friendly matches in Marseille. The first session of the second convocation of the National Assembly of Western Armenia will take place between Yerevan, Geneva, Stockholm and Beirut simultaneously through a video bridge. During the session, it is planned to discuss the credentials of the newly elected deputies to evaluate and summarize the results of the works, the election of the president and the prime minister, the formation of the government and the creation of the commissions. The State Television Company of Western Armenia informs the detailed information on the dates and venues of the meeting will be announced in the coming days. Seven Kurdish parties have decided to participate in local self-governing elections on March 31 under the name of Democratic Party of Nations. They made an announcement about this during the press conference. President Armenak Abrahamian expressed his opinion about the elections of March 31, which will also be held in the occupied Western Armenia. First of all, let's consider the alliance of different pro-Kurdish parties that indicates to their desire aimed at winning other parties which have different ethnic or political tensions in the local elections. These parties are determined to create more democratic Turkey, which will take into consideration the rights of minorities. As for Western Armenia and our people, we are indigenous people of their land. Political issues do not arise in the same way. Our people live in their territory, which is recognized as a state by the Supreme Council of the Allied Powers and now is occupied by Turkey. Since the times of Tanzimat, Turkey has been discussing the issues of democratization, which brought to genocide and the illegal occupation of our state. The consequences of the occupation and genocide against Armenians means that Turkey owes Western Armenia, and that debt is increasing every day. People of Western Armenia should not participate in the elections held in Turkey, because these elections do not have anything in common with them. It is also necessary to take into account the fact that our nation is still suffering from the denial of the right of living and existing, mentioned Armenak Abrahamian. Kurdish deputy Ferhat Anjo made a speech in the Turkish parliament emphasizing that it would be concise and accurate. During his speech, Kurdish deputy talked about the territories that are still occupied by Turkey. He mentioned about the fact that Armenians, Greeks and Kurds lived in those areas. You call this your land, but it is not true. This is not your land, nor in the land of Erdogan's party. This land belongs to its real owners and the history is the witness of this fact. Your Turkey is stolen from Armenians, Greeks and Kurds. History is my witness and you can't deny it. I am one of those people who live in this land for thousands of years. You came and occupied it, said the Kurdish deputy in his speech. After his speech, other Turkish deputies of the Turkish parliament threatened to kill Ferhat Anjo or even send him to the prison. After the Christmas church service in Nicosia, members of Cyprus Armenian community have been asked to provide DNA samples for research that aims to map the genetic background of the Cypriot population. Armenians celebrate Christmas on January 6, and the Cyprus Institute of Neurology and Genetics, which is carrying out the research, has chosen this date as the most suitable for the DNA collection, since on that day more people come to church than usual. Members of the Armenian community over the age of 18 who were born in Cyprus participated in the project. The aim of the study is to identify the genetic profile of Armenians living in Cyprus, reported Cyprus Mail. The team has already published the results of a similar study on Greek and Turkish Cypriots. According to the member in the Cypriot House of Representatives, Vardges Mahdesyan, there are around 4,000 Armenians living in Cyprus. The Armenian community in Cyprus consists mostly of descendants of the genocide survivors. Armenians settled on the island since 578 AD, mentioned Mahdesyan. The Genocide Education Project has begun a 2-year project to provide the California Department of Education with educational program on the genocide against Armenians. The representatives of the project will hold two teacher training workshops scheduled for June 2019. The Texas State Board of Education has updated its education standards to include the genocide against Armenians as an example for genocide which students must be able to identify. From 1894 to 1923, in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, the indigenous Armenian people underwent genocide by the three Turkish governments. A talented Dutch illustrator, engraver, and poet of the late 17th century, Jan Luyken, lived and worked in Amsterdam. His engravings are considered monumental. A series of ancient world alphabets by Jan Luyken were published in Amsterdam by a publisher and scholar, Wilhelmus Goyer. It is considered to be one of the first engravings where letters are accompanied by the depiction of their names. In the Armenian version, A, Aib, B, Ben, G, Gim, and etc. The series of engravings also include Syrian, Phoenician, Egyptian, and other alphabets. As we have already announced, the national team of Western Armenia had a camp in Marseille from 3 to 10 January. The team spent trainings under the leadership of former captain of national team of Armenia, Harutyun Vartanian. On 5 January, the national team of Western Armenia played a friendly match with French football club Nîmes Olympique and lost the match. In January 9, the national team of Western Armenia played the next friendly match with Toulon. The trainer of the national team of Western Armenia, Harutyun Vartanian, summarized the camp, mentioning that he hopes that the team will show good results in the upcoming championship of Confederation of Independent Football Associations. This is all for today. Goodbye.